Hey guys, welcome to episode 27 of Simple Ken. As you can see, it's very different. We have a lot of guests and we have Prashasti, we have Shija, we have Kanan. And now we will play the intro song. Back from the intro.
Time for simple. Yes. It's time for simple.
It's not a podcast. We're not holding mic.
Oh, holding a mic. Actually, also, see, awaz amplified nahi aa rahi hai, so I just wasn't used to.
Yeah,
I'll speak in this.
It's for the audio listeners who
got it.
Who don't feel like this like deserves visual attention.
Got it.
Yeah, I don't know why you do a video podcast. It's just so much more work. There's no need.
I don't know, man. I think if it's on video, like you can see people's like...
Yeah.
I don't know, expression.
Non-verbal cues.
Yeah,
like, I know what a video is. Like, I feel like they're explaining what a video is to me.
Benefits of a video is explained.
It sounds like you've written like some, you've done mass com and then told you to draw two columns between benefits of video.
No, this is a joy I feel like to make up a story between people's relationship. Like in their head, they'll be like, I feel like Kanan and Kenny don't actually like each other. Like, you know? Stuff
they
like
got that from the video. Huh?
Yeah, stuff like that you can only do from video. Audio, it's...
Audio, you have to be very passive-aggressive.
Yeah.
Like, solid, cool. Bahut bol raha hu.
And the biggest problem with radio is you don't know the face. You need to put a voice to the face so you can decide how to judge. So...
Right.
Radio can't judge the person. It seems like this ideal, flawless person talking.
Yeah.
But in video, when you see them, you're like, ye to cute. I don't trust anything this person is saying.
Right.
That's why I don't know. This is all like, now this is planned. And also, the reason why I have all of you, thank you for coming, is I've come back from Goa to Bombay.
Mm.
And Bombay is a melting point of comedians. So I was like, it'll be awesome if we can get as many max comedians and see what happens.
Okay.
So the first question
I
thought would be interesting is we all have to describe what we think is our comedy style.
Oh, shit.
Hey, don't do this.
Because there's a full arc here.
Can I describe your comedy
style? No.
Describe each other.
That'll eventually happen. But you have to first start with your, what you think is your comedy style.
Hmm.
And then if you feel it's completely off, we can interject and be like, no.
Okay,
so I'll start with my style.
Yeah.
So no one's starting. My style is very day-to-day, observable jokes, but unnecessarily made absurd or exaggerated, and it's obviously clearly directed towards everyone in the family. So it's little like simple jokes.
I wouldn't say unnecessarily made absurd. I feel like the absurdity is real. Yeah.
No, I mean, it's like, why did you go there? You could have not done that. You could have just kept it simple.
I know, but like if you do a joke about a chappal and you're like, one chappal is here, one chappal is there, chappal on the second floor is like, main to yahan par kya kar raha hu. I feel it's necessary.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's not a joke.
Yeah.
That's fair.
I think all your observations are characterized.
Yes.
You personify all of them.
Yes.
Yeah, that's my...
So that's true.
Yeah.
So
I have broken the ice.
Asi to mujhe bhi aati hai.
I have broken the ice. Now next tool.
I think I know what I do right now. I just don't know, want to say this is my style forever.
Mm.
But I know I the only thing I do is I make jokes on the things I've experiences I've lived and whatever I've observed. Like being, how do you put it? I can't make jokes on anyone else but me.
Oh.
So even if I have to make a social commentary, I have realized that I become the
vessel.
I become the bigoted person, or I become the sexist person.
Oh.
Because the only person who I can make I feel like I can make jokes on is me. Everyone else, I'm like, is meri kya aukaat? Like, is such a
fun. So I think Prashasti is like story comic.
Right,
because I think if you're given 2 minutes, you just can't do justice to
correct. I really struggle with short jokes. Like, if I'm doing a short joke, it's like it's an aberration, kabhi aa gaya, but I need to, like, it has to come from a character experience.
I think Prashasti is philosophical comic.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean,
agree.
I mean, like, in the sense, she really goes deep into the why of any situation. I feel
ladki sahi aage jayegi
wow. Yeah, aur aage jayegi.
Yaar, mujhe aisa hi bola kya? Main bola ki main aise kaise bol dunga?
It's a lot of wisdom hidden with, like, she's trying to sound floopy and immature, but she's actually very
how much, because ek aadh line aise aa jati ki are 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 kya bol rahe ho bhai.
Yeah, that is true, guys.
Would you ever go full philosophical? Like, do you think that'll scare off people?
I know. I sometimes I write it like that, but I don't have the skill to make it funny right now. Like, I genuinely would love to do that, but every time I attempt it, it becomes very bad poetry types. It doesn't like it's. I
we all hate bad poetry. That's awesome. I think that's pretty apt with Prashasti.
Yeah,
Fija.
I think from what I've been told, mine is more of a child on stage.
Hey, who put this child on stage?
Yeah, it's a child, a delusional child, probably about to throw a tantrum, sort of. Mm. I think that from what I've been told, and could also be right, I think.
Yeah. You agree that that's your type of...
Could, yeah, some of it is at least.
But when you're writing, you feel like it's like a child.
Yeah, I know some of what I'm writing is fully delusional. Like, this is...
Yeah.
Yeah. It was deadpan and it's very funny superiority complex that you do on stage. Yeah. It's hilarious. She's like, I'm the best. Tum log dekh rahe ho, ye claps fully deserved by me. Because I am the best.
But do you think you're doing deadpan, or you're like, no, this is no, fully actually, expressive?
The deadpan, though, I've stumbled upon. Like, it's just the way I express.
You were quite deadpan in normal life.
Yeah, more or less. I have expressions also, actually.
Like pleasure.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, otherwise, deadpan, I mean, it's like a way of being least vulnerable on stage, right?
Oh, that's why people are deadpan.
At least that's why I'm like, maine koi mehnat nahi ki thi is joke pe, to nahi chala to theek hai.
Oh, sort like that.
All right, she made a shield to hide behind.
Actually, that's true. Sometimes when I'm having a bad day and I'm just fed up of getting validation from the audience, I'm like, no, I'm not performing this joke. Yeah, I'll just do it like this, and if it works, it works. Yeah. Take it or leave it on the bad days. So I think maybe hiding vulnerability works with deadpan.
I just remembered I'm not wearing my glasses. I'm wondering why half of you are out of focus.
Oh man, we do miss all the fans of Uncle Kannan are missing. Sexy Uncle Kannan.
Yeah, but what a great way of describing a comedy. Out of focus.
I'm out of focus.
Yeah, Kannan, how do you describe your comedy?
I've tried to do every conceivable style.
Okay.
Or deliberately. From the starting. I was like, I want to do everything. I did. But I started with one-liners, I did music, I did observation, I did situation. And in doing so, I have become generic.
Yeah. I'm sorry, no one thinks of you that and thinks of generic.
The most recent special I did was a challenge. I was like, I want to do many different types of jokes that I never did before. So there's also the audio-visual cues. There's some sort of absurd stories, real stories. There's pure observations. There's some like dark stuff. Meta narrative. So, what is the? There's no genre. It's just you. Kuch bhi karte rehta hai. Yeah.
He's high IQ comedian.
Plus, like, I think he's challenging.
He's loving this. He's
like, I do sad comedy for sad people.
Sad, yeah.
Very sad. And
plus, I think he's challenging his audience too. Like, ye like karke dikhao. Oh. To ye bol diya maine.
Yeah. Everybody, yeah.
We're
every
going
year,
there now.
Every
now
year, less people. That's the goal. Every year, more, less relevant.
Does it annoy you that your audience gets on board with the joke too fast?
No.
Because it's maybe like that's how you challenge yourself. Ki, oh, this was too easy.
Yeah, but I know it's like whoever signed up to follow like a few years ago is not interested in the current thing. And new people sign up for the current thing, won't be interested in the next thing. Well, that's life, you know. Can't keep doing the same thing.
This is sad, high IQ comedy. He'll say something very traumatic and he'll smile at the end of it. Wait. That's life, no?
You can't, nobody told you what to do before you started comedy.
That's true.
Okay, this is what people forget in the middle. Okay, when people tell you to stick to something, they weren't there when you started it. So why should I start listening to you now? I want to do the next thing.
I think that I've realized over the past year. Yeah. That like, why am I making somebody my boss again? Just started doing comedy to not have people tell me that this is what you should be doing. Or this is what
if you don't like it, someone else will like it, man. Yeah. It's fine.
Speaking of boss, Prashasti rightly brought up. I think Prashasti has been in the proper working industry for years. So have you, Kanan.
Only 3 years.
3 years? Yeah. Prashasti, like, many years, right?
Man, I mean, yeah. After MBA, 4.5. And before MBA, 3.
Whoa. Oh, Shreeja also 3 years?
2.5.
2.5.
Oh, okay. Huh. So, I'm the only guy.
Who's never. One day you went for work, right?
No, 2 months.
Okay, so that's something.
Yeah. And I just stopped coming. I didn't send a letter saying...
You absconded?
I just absconded. Oh, and they call after... It is kind of like an hourly job, like they pay you for hourly thing, but they want you to work 8 hours a day. And I stopped coming for 2 months, and then they call after 2 months saying, "Hey, you're not coming back, are you?" I said, "No." They're like, "Okay," and then that is done. So it was a.
What was the job?
My family. No, I can't. I don't know if they can come back and bite me for this. But
don't say. Just say what the company what did, kind? Not what the name of the company.
It did subtitling.
Oh.
Yeah. So, pretty thankless job.
Pretty thankless.
Tough job.
Technical
needs
job.
Needs to be done. Yeah.
It's just time consuming. You have to watch and sync and write. So I wanted to ask how is during job comedy writing motivation and now comedy writing motivation? Because I'm guessing when you were in the job, comedy writing was escape.
Yeah.
It was like anything other than this.
Yeah.
But now you're not escaping from anything. So then what is the...
It's the common experience everyone who quits their jobs to do comedy has. It's a singular experience. That before, you're just a wellspring of ideas. Everywhere, you just have work. You have 5 minutes. You're like 5 minutes of beauty. Just jokes just come on.
Local train.
You're just standing like this. You're like, you know what? What is the meaning? Oh, I got it. 5 minutes. Yeah. You go on stage. It fucking is gold right there.
Yeah.
Then you have the full day. And not one
full year has passed, by the way, last year.
The problem with being your own boss is being your own employee.
Yeah.
Okay? Because you are a bad boss and you are a worse employee. You'll tell yourself to do something and then you won't do it. And then you'll call your comedian friends in the evening and be like, man, I'm not doing anything. And by collective mediocrity, we are keeping the whole standard of comedy in the country down.
Anyone works too hard, we ostracize them.
Someone
like, comes you get out of this.
Someone goes viral suddenly and they'll go.
Yeah.
And we'll be like, hey, you can't go. You'll come here only. Same WhatsApp group, they'll be like, I'm very, very sad. Yeah, yeah, sabko hota hai. You quit your job.
I'm feeling
sad. Then they become my fans. Sad comedy for sad people.
That's the eventual.
Yeah.
Oh man, I've started looking down upon people who work hard now. I'm like, that's not how it's done. It's supposed to be natural.
Like, you have to step back and listen to the environment. Listen to your feelings.
Bait kar thodi na likha jata hai. Leta jata hai pehle.
I feel like I call it like the homework analogy, which is like when you have to do homework, you do everything except your homework.
Yeah.
Aww.
And like I remember when I was in 10th and 12th boards, I just shot so many videos.
Ha.
And then the moment I finished school, I didn't shoot anything.
Yeah.
I think maybe it's like a nice trick where you have to do some responsible stuff and you're like.
Yeah.
You tune out and you start writing jokes.
No, I do tell everybody, you need something else in your life besides comedy.
Yeah.
Because then otherwise you will just go insane. You need something else. Get a hobby. Hang out with your friends.
So, I have a thing. Like, do you think you have to be obsessive with comedy? Then only you'll become good.
I don't know. I've not done it enough. Like, I'm in the phase right now where I've discovered that I'm such a bad employee, such a bad boss. And of course, everyone told me that this is going to happen. I'm like, I am exceptional, maybe.
Yeah. Okay.
I am.
Yeah.
But no, clearly not working. So, but I've tried to do this in the sense that I've tried to be like, you know what, I'm going to get after this and I'm going to spend days and hours on it. But does it get
worse?
Work.
Yeah, no. It always gets worse for me. The more I overthink, the more I remove a word or try to redo it, that magic is gone. You shot something which we can't discuss.
We can discuss.
Can we discuss? Yeah. So you shot Amazon Funnies.
Amazon Funnies.
Watch right now.
Yeah, in May or June. June.
No, this is coming in a week.
This is not.
Few days actually.
Whenever it comes, you all can watch, or if you don't want to, then don't also.
Well, great sales pitch. Yeah. You know, I asked Shreya to help me with marketing my special.
Yeah.
You remember this? I'd messaged you last year.
Oh, yeah.
So, when Yours Sincerely was supposed to come out, one of the marketing ideas that Netflix only gave was like, we know you hate marketing. I was like, dude, yeah. So then I don't have to do it. They're like, just do something about how you hate marketing. So the idea was simple. I was nice. I don't want to do marketing. We'll do a mockumentary style. I'm auditioning people to be me and go do the marketing. Okay. So first I asked Arjun Kanungo if he would do it. He's totally game. And so I asked Arjun Kanungo, I'll be like, this guy looks nothing like me. Next person audition, Srija. Okay. And I'm like, perfect.
And I was supposed to come in my dad costume. Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
And she comes
like, I love her dad costume.
So then I think the story that was supposed to go is that you end up being too funny and then I get very jealous or something and I won't come out of the bathroom. And then COVID happened. So
And then COVID.
Yeah.
Okay. I was supposed to become way more popular as Kanangan. Kanangan himself. It's COVID.
Then finally I'm like, it's me guys, it's me. And they're like, no, that's Kanan. And she's like,
do you have a Kanan impression?
No.
No.
I mean, no.
Wow. This is me.
There is this weird jaw movement and I can't do it. It's
angst.
Enunciating.
Yeah.
But I don't know how to enunciate. Everyone's trying to
you
do it.
Don't. You do the most. You do the most like, actually. You are the jaw flexor. Yeah, sorry, what the question that you were asking, Shreya?
Yeah, no. So also, by the way, Shreya thought this recording was April Fool's joke. She's like, obviously, this is not happening.
While leaving, I had a little bit of
sneaking suspicion.
Some anxiety I had. Ki arey, ullu bana raha hai mujhe. Udhar bula kar ullu bana.
No, I have decided if any of my friends do April Fool's joke, they will stop being my friends.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, how immature are you?
Come on, guys.
That you're still doing this April Fool's
joke. It has to be a very low-stakes, silly joke. Like, give me your hand. Oh, April Fool's, not much.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Not some major.
Yeah. That's just unacceptable. I don't know if other people realize this, but I think comedians have very strict rules that we somehow know. Is these are the rules. If you break them, you're not doing proper comedy. So what are the rules for you? Because obviously it's very subjective. I have a joke rule ki if I'm doing a joke, I have to do it with 100% energy. If I'm not doing it, I'm doing a bad job. That's one.
See,
joke
even
rule.
A new joke, you would do it with like,
oh, you joke that I do 400% because it's not working. But like if I see a comic and they're like, why are they not giving full percentage energy to this joke? Then I'm like, okay, this is not proper.
If you think a premise is bad or it's bad comedy and you still do it, then you're a bad comedian.
Otherwise, you personally?
Yeah, otherwise you're not a bad comedian. Okay. No, it's you're for no one to judge to say that this is bad comedy. But if you knew and you still did it, that's bad comedy.
Yeah,
yeah.
See, judging is wrong.
Yeah.
I'm just saying internally we do.
Internally, I'm like, if you know in your head that this was a bad joke and you still did it, then you are a fucking bad comedy.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
The other rules is I try to tighten in joke as much as possible with act out, with everything. And basically this is... This is my thought. Thinking about this has changed so much over the years, dude. I don't even know. I don't know if I should be doing the podcast in the middle of like a stand-up crisis.
Please. We all have mini stand-up crisis.
Yeah.
It's motivated by different things. Sometimes you see a great stand-up special or a great stand-up set and you have a stand-up crisis.
Yeah.
Ki, they are pushing themselves. Why are you not doing? Then reverse happens when someone's doing tatti and the audience is just losing it. You're like, kya ho raha
hai?
But then you see that same audience come for your show and they're laughing at you and they're like, okay, so who's the idiot here?
That's a good thing, refreshing thing to think once in a while. Yeah. Show like, okay, so who's the idiot?
Yeah, who's the idiot here? Because if you have dismissed them for that comic, but they're laughing at you, that means they have good taste. So then who's wrong? Who's
right? A lot.
Yeah?
Huh? Yeah, I have, because I think I have told you about this. I was telling someone that I keep looking at the internet and I'm like, I don't fit here. Okay. And I'm not saying it's categorically stupid, but it is very stupid mostly.
Yeah.
And I think my challenge is that I don't know how to do something intelligent on it and still be good at it. And but then I'm like, when these people like the shit I do, should I be happy or not? Okay. And if my challenge is, I feel, oh, so many people are stupid. Huh? I don't want them. But then those people come for my shows and they're laughing. I'm like, okay, so are my jokes stupid now? Like, no. They're laughing at them.
Yeah, actually, you get self-reflective if something works, especially on social media. I'm like, oh, so I gave them what they wanted.
Yeah.
I'm one of them now. Oh, okay, I guess I am a conformist.
Yeah. But I remember I told you then, I'll tell you now. Obviously, it's because they're good. People are not stupid.
Yeah.
So title comedians, the people are not stupid. Mm-hmm. They know what they like and they've come for you because you're good. And stop doubting your own shit.
Yeah, but I think Rohan, they said, put a comment thing. He said, what have you learned from doing so many shows? And he said, audience doesn't know what they want. But I think the audience knows what they like, as you said.
Yeah.
Like, they don't know what they want, but when they see something they like, they will immediately respond to it.
Yeah.
And when you go to an open mic and you're just torturing the audience, like, there'll be like 20 comics. Oof. And you think the audience is tough, but when someone does a good joke, they are relieved.
They're like, oh, thank God.
Yeah, thank God. Yeah. Thank you for doing a prepared joke.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because even we don't know what we like as comedy, right? Like, even we couldn't answer that question ekdam perfectly. We like this sort of. It is instinctive.
Yeah.
What makes you like this?
I know that I have to like the person, then only I can like the comedy. I know that about myself. And I think other people are not like that. Which immediately makes perfect sense to why audience choose people for no reason. Because I like someone for some bizarre, unconscious reason. Maybe this face looks like my relative. That's why. Like, you know? So I'm like, if my decision to like a comic is so arbitrary, then even our audience can't blame. Maybe this has come like because you look like their uncle or something. What is this comedy crisis you're going through? Just tell us.
We have to talk about this.
No, this is like, you've seen that Billie Eilish interview where she's every age.
I have a simple can at every age.
Yeah, simple can at every age. So after 4 years, we'll see what new crisis. The Kannan is cursed with too much introspection. Okay. Kannan is like if Kannan was a dog.
I'm just like, I watch myself on your videos and I'm like, who the fuck is this guy, dude?
Shut yeah, up. So Kannan is like a dog. If, you know, you take a dog for a walk, he'll smell everywhere. He'll go talk to other dogs. Kannan, if he was a dog, he would just be in the center of the park and look up. It'd be like, if this is just one of the parks, what are all the other parks I haven't visited? So what is your current comedy crisis? And we'll also share, we'll also relate to it.
This is nothing to do with anything. So basically, I'm saying I watch myself on your podcast. No, I watch myself on Surbhi's podcast. And I'm like, this is fucking, are you this guy?
Wait, that was a year ago.
Yeah. But
so you changed a lot from that.
No, that's why I was like, I'm not being forthcoming with the crisis.
But that's the thing. Like, let's have a Billie Eilish version of your crisis right now. Yeah. So maybe a year later we'll revisit this question.
Right.
Because we all have gone through this crisis. Like, if not now or later.
I didn't understand what the crisis is.
I have not said it yet.
But I think I figured your crisis. I think you're finding the medium too limiting.
Yeah, a little bit. But even that is such like a bullshit artistic statement, right?
No, it is. Like, it is the biggest
problem. The medium is limiting, but you go write some jokes.
We have wonderful inner voices. We encourage ourselves.
This is when I talk to myself, like, you piece of shit.
Yeah. Really? Yeah. It's like, my inner voice during the show is like, really? That it didn't work, so you just yelled it? You yelled it and you thought...
Man. Yeah, like, sometimes I'm performing and midway through I'm thinking, hey, chubek. Chub.
It happens. Like in the show, like, oh, the second stream, abhi off hai, show chal raha hai. The second stream starts and like, fuck you, fuck now. Yeah. Okay, this one won't shut up now. This one will keep talking.
Yeah, yeah. Re-enter the show by doing something like,
yeah.
You're like, okay, I did this. Now I'm here. Right. Yeah. Okay.
You know what's insane? If you watch the recording of that video and the pauses you thought you took to think that thought is like microseconds.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's incredible how you're doing two things. And I don't think regular people who are not comics do this. And we constantly switch out. Like we'll talking.
Yeah.
Like I'm right now when we were recording. Many times we switched off and be like, how's this going? Is this going good?
What are these guys thinking behind the cameras? Are they enjoying it? Yeah. Are they like, oh fuck, I just want to go home?
Should I be funny comic today? Should I be philosophical comic today? Yeah, should I genuinely answer this question?
Yeah.
Does this room need jokes? Does this room need pauses?
Yeah.
And like, be here, it won't get going otherwise.
Yeah.
At least four times I've thought this, yeah.
Ooh. Yeah, so I don't think other people do this. And I think it's very frustrating for non-comedians when they talk. That's non-comedians. When they talk to us, they don't understand kitkit kyun kar rahe ho.
Yeah.
You're not satisfied with this conversation? Oh, this is not intellectually. Just be in the conversation first. First be in the conversation, then decide.
Yeah. And then when you're in the conversation, now you're making bullshit jokes. Then you're like, I wish you weren't in this conversation. Now you're like, I'm sure all of us do this because we're comedians. If it's something someone's talking about and it's boring or either you don't want to talk about it, you'll just take something and make a joke, just hoping that you can change the subject.
Yeah. Or I'll do the opposite where I'm like, maybe if I get into it more,
it'll get
more interesting.
Yeah.
But...
tell me,
at least I'll get to know maybe their world.
Yeah.
You know, if it's a boring story. It's like, oh, your mother had 7 sisters.
Okay. Exactly.
Yeah. Something.
And I feel so evil because I'm making them talk so much and at the same time I'm judging it so much.
Yeah, fully.
Still boring.
And I don't think they do that. No, I don't think they are doing this.
Yeah.
I think everyone does it, dude. I don't think this.
Everyone has a voice in their head.
No, but not simultaneously.
No, I'm sure.
Yeah. I mean, maybe it's not correct. It's not so much. But when I was in office also, I remember I used to be like, kya bhencho, kya kar rahe ho?
Yeah, like everyone, kabhi kabhi lagta hai ki ye isne dimag mein rehearse karke line boli hai.
Yeah.
Sabhi saath lagta hai. I mean, I've done it on this in the past few minutes a lot of times. This line is rehearsed.
Yeah. No, but that's actually a great point. I think that's the only way to do comedy. The difference between a good joke and a normal sentence is we have done 3 drafts in the head. No matter how instinctual we think we are, we'll be in a friend group. I do this. We'll be in a friend group. Someone says something. I'm like, by the time they finish this paragraph, I'll have a punchline ready. And while they're finishing out the paragraph, I'll be like, for example, 7 sisters. Acha, so did you have 7 dwarfs also? but I practice. So you must have had 7 dwarfs. No, that's not true. You must have had. Oh, how about you do? Then you must have had 7 dwarfs also and pretend and look around. So
you think of a keyword basically.
Keyword. It's not just the joke. It's the joke, and you also think about how it will be received.
They will all love it.
Yeah,
and they will all be like, wow. Me.
And the world can explode and everything will be fine because I was happy at the end of it. I will ride the ship onto in the blackest of oceans.
Yeah. And if it doesn't work, I will just shrug and won't care.
So it's this curse of self-analyze. No, I won't call it self-awareness. Self-analyzing is why most people become writers or comedians.
Yeah.
I think the louder the voices, if you can, I think, submerge the voice, you become writer. If it's the voice is performing also, you become stand-up comedian.
When I went for therapy, she said, well, this is overthinking. Huh. And I was like, are you a therapist? What is you don't know any other words? Who says overthinking? Overthinking? Anyone on the road, if I tell them I think too much, she's like, overthinking.
Yeah.
She's like, it's overthinking. I was like, you come back tomorrow.
How do you think I write material?
Overthinking. It's no overthinking. It is thinking.
Do you have separate? Okay, I do this. I have civilian Kenny and comedian Kenny.
Hmm.
Like, do you guys have that side?
I don't know how to put it. So definitely, I'm very diplomatic. As in my office, for example, no one can believe that I do comedy now because I used to be very like unfunny person. Okay. But in my friends, I remember I used to be naturally funnier. And now when I'm with my friends, I actually censor myself a lot because earlier it was easy to be funny. Now I'm judging myself so much while I'm with my friends also. So I'm like, agar ye properly funny nahi hua. So
given it more value because now it's your job?
Yeah.
So are jokes like a commodity that you can't just give off for free? Or you're like,
how do I put it? Earlier, if I'm telling a story 5 times to 5 different groups of friends, it's just a story I'm telling, okay? And every time, I'm not minding even repeating the jokes I said last time because I did not have this comedian consciousness. Now I'm like, what is this? This joke that I said last time, how can I tell it again? Right? I have to tell the story with all new jokes. Otherwise, I'm doing fiction with them. So I get very like bungled up in my head. So unless I'm like inebriated or something. I'm like, tum hi log bol lo yaar, meko to stage pe bolne ko milta hai.
Right.
Prashas is great. She'll be a great teacher. She's great at explaining concepts at a very fundamental level. Many times when we were writing CPL and if I didn't understand something, Prashas will just be like, okay, Kenny, sometimes people have two preferences, like apple, pomegranate. And I was like, fuck, this is zero doubt I have. And processing and she takes the time to do that.
Ah.
Like, I don't have the patience.
Well, then this is a new side of processing.
We've worked together a lot.
Oh, Prashasthi is not like that.
The whole thing is like, well, I've asked Prashasthi one thing and now it's 2 hours later. Okay. And then she's like, main to kahan se kahan chali aati.
Kuch bola to? He keeps listening. There was a phase, we were writing something and I was telling him things about my personal life.
Oh, that's what never happens.
Guys, we were writing a show called Galaxy TV, which has been rejected by every online platform in existence. That we had the respect to go
for
to.
It being too good.
Huh? Exactly. Yes, that's the worst part. And they were like, this is mind-blowing. This is revolutionary. It's great. We love it. We've heard nothing like it. So we were like, bana do fir. Bana do nahi sakte. But compliment like a fuck off.
Full laugh game.
We're killing in meeting rooms. Everyone made us do 3 meetings and then be like, this is insane. You are revolutionizing the comedy scene, but do it somewhere else.
But while writing the show, Kannan was showed interest in knowing me. Okay. Because the protagonist was, and without people showing interest also they know so much. Okay. So every day
third choice.
Getting ready to go tell Kannan about my life. Okay. It was so much fun. Hours of going back and one day I'm like, people tell me a lot of things. Okay, that is when I'm like, oh.
I was not digging at you.
I mean,
yeah.
I don't know why people keep telling me their things. Tell me everything and go away. And then I gave someone else's example also, but I'm like, oh my god.
Oh, wow.
Like at Soho House, I have tea and I tell Kannan things. Working process.
Again, I think this is a comic thing to be conscious of how much you're inputting and outputting.
But that was a lot.
Yeah. I remember we had a little break from the show. Then we've written it 5 times.
Yes. Must be a really good show.
Fucking time. It's very good, but too good to be made. Okay. And so we had a little bit of break before the 5th rewrite. And then Prashasthi was reading episode 8. She was like, "Ito, maapko bahut zyada bata diya maine." The protagonist is writing poetry about her boyfriend. Yeah. And we use an actual boyfriend's name. Oh.
He made some change.
Oh man. And Kannan is he's like an eagle with observation. Yeah.
I have no observational skills.
What? Yeah.
No, like subjectively very strong and subjectively not there. Like,
what does that even mean?
Like, it really depends on if I'm not interested in paying attention to something. I have no idea what's happening. In my house, we moved from Bombay back to Bangalore and many boxes were delivered to my house and I left them and they were just there. Then my friends came and they're like, yo, this house is full of boxes. And I was like, I don't see it. I just chose not to see it. And I just lived in boxes for 3 months until another friend came and like, I'm going to clean this for you. I was like, you don't have to. And then she did.
Is this a metaphor for?
For what?
Like how like we...
For life.
All the things we've boxed up in our life. And we until our friends bring it up, we choose to not...
No, it's about real boxes.
Okay. It's just...
There was the TV unit already in my house, and then I got another TV unit delivered, and then
oh yeah,
I had two TV units.
No, that
just kept one in front of the other, and
two
I was like,
TV units.
I was like, where am I going to move this? So I just didn't
TV,
move.
Na?
Rakhne ka.
Yeah. Oh, acha.
No, Kanan like
TV
money on
TV ka stand.
There were two of them, and in front of that there were boxes, and then I was just like, so what do you want me to do with this? And so I just watched TV.
So now you have two TVs,
two TV units.
Two TV units.
What is a TV unit? Got it.
Yeah.
I think the thing that holds the TV, yeah.
Oh.
No. The TV unit is built. I can't believe this.
You TV unit is the
below
furniture.
The TV.
Got it.
Yeah. Yeah, where you where you put the stand on the TV.
You put a VCR.
Cabinet below the TV.
Oh, okay.
The people actually put on the wall.
It's where you put
furniture.
Your gramophone.
Okay.
I understood.
Yeah, she answered. We've got it.
You know, we're talking about TV cabinets for 2 minutes, judging other people's conversations.
See, we are so fucking interesting. Just by virtue of having a podcast, we've been like, just a mere conversation is entertainment, friends. Not just audio entertainment, it is video entertainment.
Video.
So, isko dekho aur enjoy karo. And watch this next ad. And if an ad plays right here, it'd be fucking amazing.
I'll put an ad, I can put.
You can put wherever you want.
I can put mid-roll ads.
Oh, shit.
Guys, any tech doubts, ask me.
Oh, man, I've been out of the YouTube
game. But you can decide at which point it comes.
Yes. If you have a video longer than, I think, 12 or 13 minutes, you can choose a midpoint, two midpoints where to put an ad. That's if you notice, if you see these movie reviews, they'll be like, okay, finally, let me tell you about the ending. And right when they do that, they put an ad.
So you will
watch the ad and then know.
Wow. Takeaway is you watch movie reviews on YouTube.
Huh? I love watching movie reviews. Right. I like finding about other people's opinion on things so that is my opinion.
Now. Yeah.
Yeah.
I do that with Wikipedia. Open the main page. It's like, what is photosynthesis? You're like, photosynthesis. And then you scroll down, it says criticism. I'm like, I knew this shit. It's a bad example because no one is criticizing photosynthesis. But anytime a Wikipedia page is criticism, I just like, I knew it.
I do that all people. Everyone is getting hype. Ki ye amazing. Queen ko kuch bol rahe hai, queen ki dadi ko kuch bol rahe hai. I'm like, problem kya thi inke saath?
Yeah.
What did she do wrong?
It's like a whole subset of content, no? Which is reaction and opinion. And when reaction videos came out, it's like, what is this crap? But dude, some reaction videos are great. It's like if it's especially to anything to do with India, it's like Indian person watches a white person do Bharatanatyam.
Hmm.
And then I want to hear the Indian Bharatanatyam dancer tell me how this is good or bad.
Mm.
Like stuff like that is fascinating to me.
The criticism then.
Yeah.
Criticism is fun. Reaction is what?
No, even opinion. Like, I would love to know why you don't like a particular comic. Not because I like gossip or something.
You like gossip.
I do, but I'm just like, why? Yeah. I'm just fascinated ki why? Why do, what is, what about them should I also not like?
Sometimes it's nice to watch a reaction video to see someone praise something you like.
Yeah, that's what.
So like, this is a great song.
So I'm not
teacher
wrong.
Reacts to this song. You're like, I told you it was good.
Correct.
Then you feel happy.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. I just find it so irritating because they're pausing again and again.
Yeah.
At a piece of thing that you liked watching.
No. It shouldn't exist. I agree with you completely.
Yeah, of course.
But now that it's there.
Now that it's there.
It's like slam poetry. It shouldn't exist, but if some people are doing it, can't stop them.
How dare you in my fucking presence.
I mean, Kanan, I know
slam poetry.
Slam poetry. Anyway, you were saying, we'll come back to that. You were saying something? Did we interrupt?
No, I was saying that I much rather prefer reading a review than watching it.
Okay.
Read. Matlab, wo to,
unless it's pretentious. Like.
Mare yaar.
Which is also Kanan's second favorite topic.
No, I love it. And sometimes those videos come in my recommended. I was like, hey, this is good, man.
Do you see it?
I had to watch it like 600 times while editing it.
Yeah.
I can't watch it. I can't watch anything I'm in.
But now if you watch it, you don't have the memory.
Now I watch it like, so I forgotten all the jokes.
Correct,
so I was like, oh, fuck, this is good, dude. I sent it to Biswa. I was like, you remember we did this? And he was like, wow, buddy.
But did you all watch your videos, like stuff that you're in?
No.
First you all tell, then I'll tell.
So you do.
Yeah.
Okay.
I always do, even the cringiest shit. Even if I know while shooting that it's like a brand video, for example, or something, where I know it is not aligned with how I want my comedy to look like, I still watch it to see how bad it is. And then when it's very bad, I just mute every notification.
I'll give it 5 minutes. I'm like, if this is going where I like it going, then I'll be like, hey, nice. If it's going very badly, I'm like, this never happened.
Now you?
I watch my stuff. Sometimes, repeatedly also.
Repeatedly?
Sometimes. No, once only.
Like, I like watching my stories. Like, if I make a story, I'm like, kya banaya maine? Wow. So clever. But then again, only that day I can tolerate it. The next day is unbearable. I can't see it.
Yeah, next day, no. Stories and posts I watch, obviously, ki ye wali line logo ko badi pasand aa rahi hai. Ye sab. But like YouTube videos I watch sometimes.
Okay, it's alright. So no judgment.
That's
space.
A good healthy space.
Why not?
Dude.
Yeah.
Space. We all have all these negative internal dialogues.
But the good stuff, yeah. Like if like say like just say boss streams hote the na during the lockdown.
Now that streaming is stopped for good.
Thank God that fad is over. Yeah. So you were saying?
No, so that used to happen. So if I know something went well, sometimes just to watch it. Like sometimes I didn't want to watch a movie or anything.
So you just saw your own stream.
I relate partially.
Thanks, Prashasti.
Yeah. Like if someone messages ki aapko wo wala joke yahan pe bahut sahi tha, I will go to that stream and watch that joke.
If I put a video and they say 9-12 was damn good, I'll go to 9-12 and be like, okay.
I can't argue with brilliance.
You're saying
greatness is greatness.
So I'll just get to some quick fun questions. In proper interview settings, what are the dumbest questions you've been asked?
Typical only. Like last interviews, a couple of interviews on women's, they're always dumb. Like, we've not seen your bits, but can you do them for us? And then we'll ask questions. Like,
being funny on command is... Actually, to be fair, for a normal person, they will like, hey, you anyway do, what's the big deal?
Yeah.
But it seems very humiliating. No?
Yeah, and no, I think it's just, one is... a normal interview where you are interviewing a comedian, you already have this pitch that we are interviewing women comedians and everything. You already built it so heavily, and they're like, so I've not seen any of your whatever you do. I'm just talking to you because you're a girl and someone told me your name. So can you just repeat your bit also and tell me also about, tell me some of your feminist bits, okay? Do the joke. I'm like,
yeah.
Cheeja?
Well, it's been very generic. मुझे तो स्पेसिफिक टू मी भी नहीं पूछा. इट्स जस्ट बीन जेनेरिक. व्हाट डू यू वांट टू से टू यंग फीमेल कॉमेडियंस?
लाइक मत आओ.
बट या आई आल्सो एंड अप गिविंग डम आंसर्स ओनली. तो क्या ही है.
सो फाइनल क्वेश्चन ऑफ द शो इज आल्सो जस्ट साइड क्वेश्चन. हाउ हार्ड इज इट टू गेट होम लोन एज अ कॉमेडियन? इट्स वेरी हार्ड. सम बैंक्स डोंट रिकॉग्नाइज यू as a job. So
yeah, I got dude.
I mean, gonna accept Karan Gill because he's a Bollywood star.
That's what I say.
But I think for MADA, if you have to apply for a MADA house.
What's a MADA house?
Maharashtra Housing Something Development. Which is in
Mumbai. Delicious.
So they have houses on case kuch lottery type hoti hai.
Correct. Yeah.
Jisme then you get houses for a subsidized rate.
Yeah.
And then obviously there's levels of what.
There's a giant like lottery system.
Yeah. So that for that you can apply only if you're salaried.
Fucking they're just subjugating all us. Can't even get these lottery houses. Final question is from Khan _ Ark _ Single _ Baba.
This is going to be good.
Yeah.
Like by, from his name, I know this is going to be good.
It's too long, but in, and he also name dropped, so I don't want to name drop. But his thing was, I've noticed there's one particular comedian who only talks about one thing. So when you go to their show, they only talk about that one thing. Then I've noticed the other type of comedians who you don't know what they're going to talk about. They're not defined by one type of.
Later we'll get to read the comment.
Yeah, of course. I'll tell you who it is.
God damn.
I mean, is that it's the perspective of an audience member. So I want to ask you, ki, did you catch yourself being, oh, I am in this category. For example, I was stuck with this whole middle class jokes for a long time, even though I have one video on it.
Yeah.
And the bucket bath also is about that. After that, I just did so much absurd stuff, no one's noticing.
Kenny's pulling up to the bike and pulling up to the show on his Kawasaki Ninja. We're like, guys, so middle class, guys. It's one of my two motorcycles.
But I got stuck in it. But then I was also like, wait, if people know me as this, I guess I should just lean into it more. And people obviously responded more to, I went to Kendra Vidyalaya, I'm from this middle class family, blah, blah, blah. But when now I'm consciously trying to get out of it.
Okay.
Do you guys think you are stuck in something?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I did not expect this answer.
Fully, yeah. Especially like right now while I'm editing my set, 15-minute set, I'm like, I'm just making the same joke 15 times. And now also...
Not this much. Little bit
of one joke every minute? Damn.
And now also I'm getting similar thoughts only. Like, it's basically the same sort of things that I'm saying.
Which is
ki around this thing only ki mujhe to ladke bahut pasand hai but main reject kar deti hu or something like basically just being a chichori.
Yeah. Quote unquote.
Yeah. So like most of my jokes like, and even now I'm thinking of those, I'm like, at least now I've given these section of jokes away there, 15 minutes gone, now it's going to be different. नहीं मुझे सिर्फ फिर से वही सब थॉट्स आ रहे
हैं अच्छा
सो आई फील लाइक आई गेट
आने दो ब्रो व्हाट इज द व्हाई यू आर नॉट इन चार्ज ऑफ द क्रिएटिव एंटरप्राइज
इट
विल कम एंड इट विल लीव यू बट डू सर्विस टू द थॉट्स दैट कम
यू फील दिस वे बिकॉज़ ऑफ योरसेल्फ और द ऑडियंस इज फोर्सिंग यू टू बी लाइक दिस
आई मीन आई फेल्ट दिस वे मायसेल्फ लाइक आफ्टर हियरिंग माय जोक्स एंड लाइक आई हैव एक्सप्लोर्ड दैट सेम थॉट from every different angle. So like if I pay attention to myself, I'm contradicting myself. Shit, I've said a lot about your set. It's actually very good. I've seen it.
It's very good.
If you've noticed anything, we're very critical of our own work if you've not already noticed.
Yeah, but yeah, basically it's that. Like I feel like it's just a 360 degree view on pretty much the same thing.
So, yeah, but that's not true, man. It's okay. Oh, don't get a feel like that. But yeah, maybe because whatever creative faculty is working is like, I'm not done with this thought. Something is left.
Yeah.
You need a killer bait on this premise, put it in a boat, set it down a river, and then fire an arrow to it. It bursts into flames, and then you will be done with that premise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Give each premise a send off. Like, now this is over.
But you know, many times I've thrown like an entire tank at it, and it keeps coming back. And I'm just like, because at some point I'm like, I'll try new premises, I have no fun in it. And I go back to my nice fun subject. I'm like, you know what, fuck it, I'll just have fun on this subject.
Just what's the problem,
just do it. Yeah. Do you feel
so
I know what you're going to say.
Everyone knows what I'm going to say. Because I also, like Shrija, know that I end up talking about my being single, lack of relationship, blah, blah, a lot. And that problem keeps evolving. But the problem is sort of the same only. And I started censoring myself to be like, no, dude, why can't I talk about other things? But it's the same thing happened. The other things are not as much fun. Yeah. This angst is too pure. Okay? Yeah. And too much nice stuff come out. And I just love expressing myself on this. So now I've made my peace with this that, you know what, I worry about the country also, but can't talk about it. So basically, so like, I'm like, you know what, I'm growing up as a person, my angst is growing, and hence new jokes are coming out. So why should I be ashamed of doing it? The thing is, I need to not repeat myself, or I need to grow as an artist. My jokes need to grow. But if abhi problem agar saath saath solve nahi hua to nahi hua hai na. Everything else are solved in my life.
But so this is more from you. It's not like the audience gets more excited. What if the audience is like, I like Precious's
actually,
stuff?
Actually, it's ulta. I've seen my audience. I can see that's very easy to. Audience loves these boy girl jokes. Okay, and I hate. Now I don't do boy girl jokes when I do romance or heartbreak comedy. Also.
It's girl girl.
It's just.
Girl girl.
It's philosophical.
Nice. It's not about boy girl, it's just about life.
Me and my love.
Yeah.
Akele. So I like again I tried to become like be honest to where I am in life. But like, it's just the most fun when I write on this premise than anything else.
So what Khan is asking is, would you one day be like, fuck it, process thee from now on and only do boy-girl jokes. And if you don't like it, you can fuck off. This is what I enjoy doing. Like, or you think that's limiting as a comedian?
No, so that's what I'm saying, that I know what they like. What they like is actually not I'm doing anymore. That I know ki this dating joke na ki ladke ke chuti hote hain. That is very easy to do.
It's killing.
Yeah. No, I can do it very well. But as he said in the beginning, right? Ki as soon as I write something like that, I know this is bad joke. Oh. As in I'm just doing it because I know it will land. I have
Kanan's rule has come.
So I try to be more honest, and then I'm at peace. Then I'm like, you know what? It's tougher to get laughs here, but I'm enjoying this process.
So I like it when people say, like you said, it makes you feel very good. But it's like completely the opposite of someone. If someone says, like I said, that's fucked up.
Yeah.
If you say, like you said, you know, the stock market is a very sensible business. But if you said, like I said, the stock market is a very sensible business.
I consciously learned that from team building.
Huh?
Yeah, consciously. There are some things you have to do. One is always address people by their name. It's fucking oldest thing you heard, but it's so effective. Just really call people by their name. And it also shows that you pay attention. Yeah,
It's intimate.
It's intimate. And I think you release some endorphins when you hear your own name, because we're so self-obsessed. And the second thing is, everyone feels included. Otherwise, because I hate it when I say something and 5 minutes later some fuckers repeat what I said.
Yeah.
So I appreciate it when that person's like, like Kenny said, I'm like, yeah.
I said.
I fucking said. So it just brings the team together, because everyone's like, oh, everyone's being heard.
Yeah.
And the whole problem with every conflict in life is people feel like they're not heard.
That's true.
So that brings us to the end of this episode. I hope everyone felt heard and spoken to.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. Let's see. In the comments below. Who hates each other and who you like, and what chemistry do you feel has between us comics. And if you have any questions for the next episode, please put on the comments below. You can hear the audio version on all platforms. And thank you. And all the questions from
soon
today.
Soon on our platform. I have to ask you for your RSS feed.
I will send it to you. I'll send you on that day only.
Oh, shit. Okay, yeah, cool. I have to do
that. I'll also be on No New Notifications app.
If you don't know what it is, don't worry about it. It's too much to explain.
The intrigue. Yeah. Just go check out his podcast. You'll know what it is. And it's going to be on his app as well.
It's a competitor to Spotify.
Yeah. all the questions from today were from the Simplekin podcast Instagram page. It's just easier to get questions from there. So thank you so much for your questions. And please show some love. At this point, you'll be seeing their individual Instagram handles.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Put a wrong one for me.
Yeah, I'll put a wrong one.
Okay.
And please, if you want to reach...
a dog account.
Done.
Put the Dodo.
Oh, yeah, Dodo account. Okay. Yeah.
Hamara to sahi wala
hai. Chale, hum chale. Mera wala
hai. Priorities. Yeah. And also, Sreeja's Amazon Funny is coming out. And Prashasthi is also working on something.
Prashasthi is going on tour. Will you be on tour next week?
Yeah. If Corona doesn't fuck us over.
Okay, but so then where can they buy tickets? What's one place they can
book
see
all
your
tickets? Book my show. And my link in my bio.
So
link in Prashasthi's bio to buy tickets for her.
Yes. And if you wanna, if you're good looking, you can start a conversation. tall and good looking and also interesting.
Intellectually sound also.
A little flawed. Conflicted.
Must have a problem in life.
Yeah, conflict.
Initially, like a little bit of an asshole, but then you have to work together in a confined space. And then later,
you realize the asshole
when
is
it's raining.
Coming.
Yeah, there's he's vulnerable.
He's vulnerable, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that these guys know me.
It's every romance novel.
So yeah, so and then Kanan is just having a crisis. So if you want to give him some company,
he didn't elaborate on it. Huh?
He'll tell us later. I'll also tell you which comic.
Yeah, if we do more episodes also. Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do another one where Kanan feels more comfortable to share.
Excuse me?
Yeah, it's actually because of Precious Things. Yeah.
They're like the most aggressive comics on the scene. Yeah. Never let anyone speak. Okay, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Ta-ta. Bye-bye.